I'm Mike Sargent, and this is Arise on Screen.
We want this team's future back. Let's get busy.
In Draft Day, Academy Award winner Kevin Costner is back in the genre that helped put him on top. In this sports drama, Costner plays general manager Sonny Weaver, whose career and the future of the Cleveland Browns depend on the decisions he makes on this sacred day in football, Draft Day.
I poured everything into journalism, and I would lose it all.
Power, race, and ambition in the competitive field of journalism all led to the demise of writer Jason Blair's career. The new documentary, A Fragile Trust, Plagiarism, Power, and Jason Blair at the New York Times, uncovers the truth about Blair and the impact his plagiarism scandal had on the entire journalism community. We speak with writer-director Samantha Grant.
Jason Blair had some incredible opportunities laid at his feet, and he made some really bad decisions.
I'm a survivor. I got the eye of a tiger. Be training the game and eat to my fiber.
In Rio 2, the fun-filled sequel to the 2000 animated hit film, all your favorite Rio characters are back, joined by a few new voices, including Grammy winner Bruno Mars and Oscar, Emmy, and Tony winner Rita Moreno. Will the movie swoop its way into the hearts of moviegoers like the first one did? All this and more on Arise on Screen.
Hello, I'm Mike Sargent, and welcome to Arise on Screen, your global home for films both on screen and behind the scenes. Let's get to it first with this week's box office winners. Captain America, The Winter Soldier, tops the box office this week, followed by Noah, Divergent, God's Not Dead, and The Grand Budapest Hotel rounds it out in the number five spot. And in movie news...
The James Bond franchise may have found their newest villain in 12 Years a Slave Oscar nominee, Chiwetel Ejiofor. Rumors have it that he is the first choice of Bond director Sam Mendes. The 24th film in the James Bond film series also may have a new Bond girl. A recent schedule release has actress Penelope Cruz listed among the cast. Virtually unknown actress Maisie Richardson Sellers has become the frontrunner for a coveted role in the new Star Wars sequel, according to The Hollywood Reporter. Richardson Sellers joins a number of other contenders, including recent Oscar winner Lupita Nyong'o and John Boyega.
We don't have the luxury of taking risks and hoping for the best, because if we lose everything.
Science fiction fans of the TV hit Battlestar Galactica will be happy to hear that Universal Studios is adapting the rebooted space series into a film. According to Variety, the original series creator will produce the film that's being completely reimagined for the big screen. Godzilla. The Japanese creature from the sea returns to terrorize a new generation of movie fans.
You have no idea what's coming. And it is going to send us back to the Stone Age.
The reboot stars Breaking Bad TV actor Bryan Cranston, who faces not just a tsunami, but imminent nuclear destruction and the legendary reptilian beast.
Wow, that's great. You're the most wonderful dragon in the whole world.
The animated classic Pete's Dragon could be closer to a reboot. The online industry magazine The Wrap has reported that Disney Studios is in final talks with David Lowery to direct the children's favorite about a little boy Pete and his invisible best friend, a dragon named Elliot. The original 1977 film featured Mickey Rooney, among others. As we all know, Hollywood mourns the legendary star, who at the height of his career was Hollywood's top box office draw in the late 30s to early 40s. He never won an Oscar, but was nominated four times. Rooney famously lit up the screen with America's sweetheart, Judy Garland.
Good morning to you.
And in festival news, the golden days of Hollywood are being celebrated this weekend at the TCM Classic Film Festival, which kicked off last week. This year, they celebrate the network's 20th birthday and the 5th anniversary of the TCM Classic Film Festival itself. The festival will spotlight landmark films, the first families of Hollywood, and filmmaking dynasties that have entertained generations for a long time. The festival runs through Sunday, April 13th. Today, I'm joined by artist, filmmaker, and international film critic from Italy, Chiara Spagnoli Gabardi.
Hello.
And film critic, raconto, Julian Roman of MovieWeb.com. Welcome back, Chiara.
Hi, Mike.
Welcome, Julian.
Thank you.
Looking forward to doing the show with you. So I have to ask you both, since we're going to be talking about Draft Day, and it's Costner's new sports-themed film, what is your favorite sports-themed film? I'll start with you, Julian.
My favorite sports-themed film is The Sandlot, a classic kids film from 1993, directed by David Evans. Very cute, very sweet, one of those innocent, you know, timely films about these kids who play baseball in this, like, you know, dirty backyard. Mm-hmm. And the kid who stars in it takes a Babe Ruth-signed baseball and plays it in the game, and they end up losing it over the backyard of a fearsome dog called the Beast. And so the entire film where the kid's playing baseball and trying to cover the ball. It's just a sweet, beautiful
good
movie.
Good film. And what about you, Chiara? What's your favorite?
My favorite is Million Dollar Baby. We all know the story. I usually like when sports trigger a change in life.
Sure.
When they actually are an opportunity. So.
Great choice. Well, mine, I have to say, is Any Given Sunday, because that was one of those movies where I went to see it, went in thinking, oh, you know, I'm not a big football fan. I like playing it, but I was never big into watching sports-themed films necessarily. But Any Given Sunday, great performances by everybody. So that's my choice. But we're going to be talking about movies today, so we'll be right back.
Coming up, Draft Day. Kevin Costner, star of sports-themed hits, Field of Dreams, and Bull Durham, is back in the game. This time, he plays an NFL general manager whose whole life has been leading up to the choices he makes on NFL Draft Day. Does this latest Costner sports drama have what it takes to score a touchdown at the box office? When we return, here on Arise on Screen.
You son of a...
I need 5 minutes, and then you can fire me.
I got Tom Michaels on the line.
Sonny, are we trading six?
That was a scene from Draft Day, the new football-themed film directed by Ivan Reitman, starring Kevin Costner as a general manager who puts it all on the line and takes the biggest risks of his career. At the LA premiere, Costner and actress Jennifer Garner, who plays the love interest, talked about learning from the project.
You know, the whole movie has this real build to it, and at the end, there's a real, a huge climactic scene that goes on for a little while. And every time Kevin did the scene, every take, the whole crew gave him a round of applause because he was amazing.
I felt like I learned a lot from Ivan, and every director I've worked for, I've kind of watched what they've done because they, you know, have these different tricks, and if you're smart enough, you kind of borrow some of them.
You're threatening to fire me, Ryan. Your job is to...
Welcome back to Arise on Screen. You know, it's interesting that Costner himself is an Academy Award winning director, and he's still a student of film, that he's talking about what he learned from, you know, from Ivan Reitman. And Jennifer Garner is a Golden Globe winner, and she's talking about what she learned from acting from Costner. So, but I have to say, I agree with them both, because I think this is the best thing that Costner and Reitman has done in years. So I'm going to start with you. You like this movie? But you don't think it's going to be the kind of hit that Bull Durham and some of the other movies are?
No, Mike. It's definitely not on par with Bull Durham or Field of Dreams. I'd say it's exceedingly mediocre. If you're an NFL fan and you like football...
Exceedingly mediocre.
Ouch.
Wow. Okay.
I'd say if you're an NFL fan, you'd like it, you know, the mm-hmm. Draft Day theatrics, and it kind of counts down to the, you know, overall number one pick. But when I saw the film, I felt it was ticking all the boxes. You have Jennifer Garner as Ellie, the love interest, who, of course, on the day of the draft, tells him that she she's pregnant, and this pregnancy runs as a theme, like, do I care more about my pregnancy or my number one draft pick? So I felt that was for, you know, maybe the people who aren't into sports and themes and so on. So I felt it was a bit predictable. I mean, it'll be entertaining, I think, for some people, but not really for others.
Well, you know, it's interesting because for Ivan Reitman, I think this is a good comeback for him because, you know, his son has been making a lot of noise.
That's
and
true.
Really rising. He did Juno, he did Up in the Air. Meanwhile, Reitman's done nothing but a string of bombs. He did Evolution, he did My Super Ex-Girlfriend, he did that really bad film with Ashton Kutcher. What was it called? No Strings Attached, I think. Really bad. Now, you, on the other hand, you like this movie. You're not a football fan.
I'm not a football fan.
You said absolutely it's going to be a hit.
Yes, I think so. I'm not a sports person, therefore I was biased negatively. I wasn't expecting to like it, but I actually did. And I really enjoyed to see Kevin Costner in a more introspective role, because we've seen him this year in so many action roles. Mm-hmm. And here he was interiorizing more along the way. So, and I think the whole mood has a wonderful vibe through the sports theme. So I think it's going to work.
You think it's going to work?
Yes.
Now, I also have to ask you, I thought for me that the writing was surprisingly good. And like I said, I'm not a football fan, but I think that this will appeal. You think that they put Garner in there for that. But I think it will appeal to people like Kiara. I definitely think that this could be a hit.
I think it's coming into some serious competition. You've got Captain America basically dominating the box office, but the timing, you know, close to the actual NFL draft should serve it pretty well. And the overall pacing of the film, I think, is very, very good. But once again, I feel it's formulaic. I don't think there's any doubt what happens in the end or if they're going to win, quote unquote.
But it's a different genre to Captain America, so I don't think there's a competition there. It's just two different things.
Well, it is similar target audience because boys do like Captain America and they do like
Yes,
football.
But I don't think they competes, destroys the other. I think one can like both.
Okay. Well, we're going to move on to our next film. It's called Hate Ship, Love Ship, and it's based on the short story Hate Ship, Friendship, Courtship, Love Ship, and it's from acclaimed author Alice Munro. And it's about a pseudo-relationship that the granddaughter, who her name is Sabitha, creates between her caregiver, Joanna, played by Kristen Wiig, and her drug addict father, Ken, played by Guy Pearce, and the unexpected consequences it has on her entire family.
I waited for you to open it.
Oh my God.
Blah, blah.
Your friend, Johanna Perry.
What if she wants to write him back?
We'll put a fake email address for your dad and she'll have to respond that way.
How about you say something like, you should wear your hair back more often so the world can see your pretty face.
Thinking about you in your nightgown. Hold you in my arms.
What are you doing here?
Didn't you get my email?
I don't have email.
Julian, you found this film to be predictable and blasé, but you, on the other hand, you were waiting. You didn't know what was going to happen.
Yes, well, I wasn't very much entertained. I was waiting for the entire time to be surprised, and I was surprised not to be surprised. So I was disappointed in that way. And I didn't really like this female character who self-censors herself all along the way. There was no girl power at all, quite the contrary. So that got on my nerves a little bit.
Well, actually, you know, Julian, the one thing you said, you did like her performance. You felt she did a lot with her body and she played this introverted character, which I agree. But you didn't like the film too much either.
Well, I agree with her. I mean, the film just basically goes nowhere. It's kind of like a very, very warm soup. That's
Don't
how I would
describe
it.
Give away the ending now.
And the thing I liked about it is the fact that, you know, it's kind of a little bit sweet. You know, you kind of care for the character. But I'm with you. I was expecting something to happen. I mean, I think the term, I was surprised not to be surprised, something is up beautifully. And it's a quiet part from Kristen Wiig. I mean, we would normally see her with her antics and doing a lot of body motion. And here she's kind of frumpy, you know, kind of like a dowager. And so that works a little bit. But I agree with you. The film is very, very blasé.
Well, I agree that the film didn't have a lot of surprises. I was surprised by the ending. I won't give it away. But I thought it was going to go in a very different direction than it did. So I thought, and I also think that the supporting cast, Nick Nolte, Christine Lottie, Jennifer Jason Leigh, what a great supporting cast. But like you said, they didn't do too much with them.
They don't really do anything. I mean, they don't really have a lot of speaking lines. There's not really any conflict that arises from it. And so you would hoping there'd be more. But once again, it's like me on a first date. You keep waiting and nothing happens.
It's very flat.
Okay.
And it's a bit G-rated.
We're
not going to give it
away. We don't recommend. Okay.
No.
Well, we're going to move on and we'll be right back.
Still to come, the massive plagiarism scandal Jason Blair unleashed rocked the New York Times and the entire world of journalism. We sit down with Samantha Grant, director of the new explosive documentary, A Fragile Trust, that tells the shocking story of the disgraced journalist.
I had poured everything into journalism and I would lose it all. And I was losing it all.
Next, here on Arise on Screen.